Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This month we've been looking at By My Spirit. That's what we've been looking at, By My Spirit. And today we're celebrating children, so we're still looking at By My Spirit. In that last chorus that was sang, it says a miracle can happen now because the presence of the Lord is here. Lots of times we think that a miracle is because I want it. But a miracle comes because God wants it. We might be asking, but it's God who wants. It's God who knows what he can do to touch us. It's God that knows what he can do to get our attention. It's God that reaches out his hand. And so, let him do that. And so, in a minute here, I'm going to be looking for some volunteers. But before I do, what we have looked at so far is in Isaiah 26. With my soul, I have desired you in the night. Yes, by my spirit within me, I will seek you early. God needs to be the desire of your heart. God needs to be that great desire of your heart. Just as simple as that. And so in your early mornings, as you're beginning to wake up, if you're able to, I know some people have a rough time of mornings, begin to think about God. Begin to contemplate him. If you're not a morning person, as you lay down at night, begin to contemplate and think about God. Go to sleep thinking about God and the things he has done and his spirit. In Psalm 51:12, it says, restore to me the joy of your salvation and uphold me by your generous spirit. I got to tell you, there's lots of times where we need restoration. Say amen.
Amen.
Need great restoration. And so I share that with you. How do you know if you've been restored? You have joy. How many of you know when you have joy? You know when you have joy? When do you have joy?
Every day I have joy.
Every day. How do you know?
Because it's in my heart.
Because it's in your heart. How many knows when you have joy? How do you know you have joy, Tom? When you know that you can see the Lord all about you. Okay. Somebody else, how do you know that you have joy?
You're happy.
You're happy. Say it again.
You're happy.
You're happy. How do you know you're happy?
You smile.
Say it again.
You smile.
You smile. There are 8 times in the scripture where it talks about God smiling at us. Isn't that cool? How many's glad that you were a kid? Aaron, I'm volunteering you. Come on. Do you know what this thing is? It's stretched all the way out there. It's a tug of war? It is. There's a scripture that says, don't be unequally yoked with unbelievers. How many knows that? How many's ever heard that? Well, I don't know what all you'll get today, but hopefully when you leave, you'll know that what it is to be unequally yoked with unbelievers. So I want you to get a hold of this side of the rope. You got it good? Okay. Now, she's going to be going to high school this year, and she's real nervous about it. Cody, where are you? Come on up, Cody. Now, I want you to know, Cody's a good believer, but today he's going to play the unbeliever.
Okay. You're going to be the unbeliever today, Cody.
Grab this side of the rope. Don't put the bear out of there. Come on. Get it up above the bear. Ready? Pull. Wait until you're ready. Are you ready? Okay, go ahead and pull. A little harder. Come on, put some muscle into it. Okay, bring it back. Now, would you like some help? You would. How are you going to choose your help if you're not supposed to be unequally yoked with an unbeliever? Aren't you going to try to find somebody else that's a believer? So take a look around, pick somebody. Somebody you want to help you. You want Emily to help you? Come on, Miss Emily. Come on down. You gotta grab the rope. Emily, have you ever played tug rope before? Oh, okay. I was just making sure. Are you ready? Are you ready, Em?
Yeah.
Go ahead, pull.
Okay, that's good. That's good. That was good, Cody.
Now, Emily, I want you to go over to Cody's side. One of those that you thought was a good Christian really wasn't. Does that happen?
Mom.
How often does that happen? Say it again. Lots of times that happens. And so those that you think were on your side, all of a sudden, where? On the other side. What do you think is going to happen now? You're going to lose? You're not going to lose at what? What could you do so that you don't lose? Go to God. Take a look around. This way. She's very shy. I want you to pick out a couple of guys here that you think are really good. From way over there, all the way over, pick yourself out a couple of guys. Patrick. You need a couple. That's only one.
You don't need more than
one. Josh.
He's 2-1.
Can do Kevin? Okay. Now, before I tell Paul, what's going to happen?
We're
going to go that way. Are you ready? Because when you go to God, there's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I want you to understand, when you go to God, there's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lots of times when we're trying to pick out friends, and we think they're Christians, and it ends up that they're not really good Christians, I can still go to who? You can still go to God. And this is what keeps you from being unequally yoked with unbelievers. Does that make sense to you? This rope is life. Unbelievers are always going to try to pull you away from God.
Right.
But God's got his hand on you, and if you put your confidence in him, he's always going to be pulling you towards him.
Amen.
Is that good? Okay. Give him a hand. This is good. This is good. I need a couple of younger kids. I got... How about those two boys right there? You got
Michael.
You want to come up? Sure, come on. How are you guys at balancing? You don't know? Have you ever balanced anything on the top of your head? Have you ever balanced anything on your nose?
No.
Have you ever stood on your hands? I can stand on my hands. Are you ready? You hold that. Watch. This is a book. This is a book.
I stand on that hand. I stand on that hand.
What was that? Was you laughing at me? That wasn't quite what you thought I meant when I said I'm going to stand on my hands, right? Well, I'm not going to do it against you. They have to have a dip with a stretcher. Okay? But I've got some balancing for you guys to do. So wait right there. You know what that is? It's a tennis racket. If you listen to it, it makes a lot of noise. No, it doesn't. He's pretty smart. What I want you to do is I want you to hold that tennis racket out flat. And do you like red or do you like white? Do you like white? Do you like red? Now, what I want you to do is you're going to go this way around the aisles of the church, and you're going to go turn around. You're going to go that way around the aisles of the church, and you're going to try and keep that ball on a tennis racket. You think you can do that? Are you sure? See that aisle right there? You're going to go down that aisle there. Oops. You're going to go down that aisle there. And that guy back there with that nice yellow shirt on, you're going to turn left right there and go across the back of the church, and you're going to come up this aisle right here. And you're going to go down this aisle right here, and you're going to turn right back there and go across the back of the church, and all the way over to where Rachel is sitting, that guy in the yellow shirt too, and come up that aisle and right back to here. You think you can do that? Without dropping it. You're going to try hard not to drop it. Are you ready? No, no running, just walking. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go.
It's hard. Luscious bear up here.
It's been in different parts. You've seen it sitting in the pew back there.
You see it sitting in the pew up there. You see it sitting in the basket over there.
You see it hiding underneath the communion table. You saw it sit up here on the stage while they were playing the bass and guitar and all that kind of stuff. How many knows if this bear is a girl or a boy? You've watched it for several months. How many of you think it's a girl? And why do you think it's a girl? It's got pink feet. And a pink bow? That's pretty cool. It's got a pink bow. I'm going to ask you a question about this. How many knows how many times a bear is mentioned in the Bible? Anybody?
Once?
Where David and Goliath is? Okay.
David fought the bear, lion.
Bear.
At least three.
There are over 290 times where bear is mentioned in the scriptures.
That's at least three.
But a lot of them are not the animal bear. Like I'm bearing a burden. Or I'm bearing a child. Or I'm bearing a load. There's a whole lot of different types of bears that are out there. But for actual animal descriptions, there are about 14 or 15. A lot of them are used like similes or metaphors, where like a bear or as a bear, so on like that. It's interesting that of all of those metaphors, all of the time they always refer to a female bear. The most popular metaphor that you see in the scripture is a mother bear robbed of her cubs. Isn't that interesting? We don't actually know what kind of bear it was that David killed. But we know that in the book of 2 Kings, there were some very disrespectful young men that were teasing a prophet named Elisha. And Elisha looked at them, and God had him command that she-bears, female bears, come out of the woods and maul those young men. Bears are a pretty bad rap. What do you think? The passage description that I like is in Isaiah, where it says the bear and the calf will feed together. Not the bear eating the calf, but the bear and the calf feeds together. That'll happen when who's in the house?
Jesus.
When Jesus is in the house. So I call this my prayer bear. If you would like to have a chance at winning this prayer bear, I'd like you to come on up now. Anybody that would like to win this prayer bear? Come on up. Oh, we're getting a few. Let me tell you what you got to do. In the book of Ezekiel says, we growl like bears. That's what it says in the book of Ezekiel. We growl like bears. Have you ever heard anybody growl? You have? Yeah, you all have? Well, we're going to have a growling contest. And since you're the only girl, we're going to let you growl first. And all of you are going to be the judge. Okay, you got this? You're the judges. Give us your best bear growl.
Oh.
Are you ready? Are you guys going to give us a prayer growl, one of you? You don't have to. Okay, come back over here. We're already down to two. That went really quick. Less quicker than I thought it was. You need to pump up a little bit to give us your next best bear growl? You all ready?
Okay.
How many things this one wins?
She really has to have a better choice because we enhanced it, so they have to have an even choice. So they both have to do it over again.
They both have to do it.
By some people are telling me they have to do it over again.
Come on, man.
It really sounds good. You did a good job.
Riley just stole your toy.
I don't know what Dad is telling you. You don't know either? Are you ready?
We're going to go first this time. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, how many thinks this is one? Now, hang on. You can have a seat now. We started this before. Let me tell you about this bear. This bear is a prayer bear. Do you know what a prayer means? Prayer is when you talk to God. So, you can sleep with this bear, you can wrestle with this bear, but when you're with this bear, you have to start by having a prayer. Say, God, bear with me. That's the whole prayer. Say that with me, God.
God, bear with me.
Very good. Do it one more time.
God, bear with me.
And if you say, God, bear with me, guess what he's going to do?
He's going to bear with you.
There you go. If you are able to blow up a balloon, I need you to blow up a balloon for me. So hold up your hand. We'll start right over here. I'm going to tell you a story on Tom. Years ago, we were with a bunch of boys, and we were putting them on inner tubes and sliding them down a hill, and next thing you know, somebody grabbed me and put me on an inner tube. It was Tom. Gave me a push right down a hill. Anybody else? I got more balloons. And they have those nice banners of all the military personnel that have been in foreign wars and stuff. It's a den of Miles. One of those has Miles' pictures on it. I think it would be nice to get him now standing underneath that picture where he looks like a kid in that picture. Right, Miles? There's a passage of scripture that says, be angry and sin not. How many knows that scripture?
Miles.
How many ever uses it just for an occasion to be angry? You never use it for an occasion to be angry? That's good. Right now I want you to take this and give it your angry blow. Ready?
and then pinch it, just one blow, and pinch it. Here's has a hole in it. How'd you do that, Deb?
She wins.
Okay, you got angry once, but you got to pinch, okay? You're not letting it out. So, ready, get angry again, give me another angry blow. My mom's holding her ears. Notice it got what?
Bigger.
Ready? One more angry blow.
That's as far as I'm going.
That's as far as you're going.
Don't go any further.
How many would like to know what it means to be angry and sin not?
What?
How many would like to know what it means to be angry and sin not? What it means to be angry and sin not is to know how to let your anger out without it harming anybody. That's what it means to be angry and sin not. To let your anger out without harming anybody. That's what it means. You see, all of us get angry, but there's ways to express your anger without harming anybody. You have to find what that is. Maybe it's running. That works, doesn't it, Sherry? Running. Get that all out of your system. Maybe you need to just step into a place and give a scream to get that all out of your system. But you need to find something that's not going to harm anybody, because you know what would have happened if we would have blown one more breath in that balloon. There would have been an awful eruption. And that's what happens to a whole lot of us. Amen?
Amen?
We end up with an awful eruption. And unfortunately then, it's broken. You can't put it back together. You can't take it home to enjoy it anymore, because you've already done something that has been irreparable. But there is a God who is able to help you know how to let your hot air out of your balloon. There is a God who is able to let you show you how to let your hot air out of your balloon. It comes by the Spirit. How many understand that? And so when it talks about the Spirit giving us life, the Spirit blows not hot air, but good air inside us. I don't know about you, but I like really good air. I like really good air. And if you'll bow your heads with me, Heavenly Father, this day, in the name of Jesus, by your own Spirit, we ask, Lord, that you give us really good air. Lord, as we started out with saying, help my spirit to desire you. Help our spirits to desire you. Help us, Lord God, to be hungering and thirsting after you. Help us, Lord, in our choice of friends, to realize we need to rely on you first, that you can direct us to if we can have friends that will strengthen us and not try to pull us down. Help us, Lord God, that we can spend some time with you in prayer, Lord, that you will be our comforter, and God, that your spirit will quicken us. In Jesus' blessed, holy, marvelous name, amen. Greet one of these kids. God bless us.